Hello and welcome back everyone. It's time for our year 2 science lesson. We are still in unit 7, electricity. Today we're going to learn about building an electric circuit. So if you're ready, let's get to it. Let's go. Alright boys and girls, let us do some revision first. As you can see here, in our previous lesson, we have learned about identifying the electrical components. What are the electrical components that we have learned? The first one is dry cell, bulb, and switch. Do you think is that all? No, isn't it? As you all know, to build an electric circuit, we also need some additional components such as dry cell holder, bulb holder, and connecting wires. If you still remember, in our previous lesson also, we have learned about the functions of the electrical components, such as dry cell to supply electrical energy, bulb to produce light, and switch to complete and break an electrical circuit. Alright boys and girls, as you can see here, our topic for today's lesson is building an electric circuit. Actually, we can build a simple electric circuit by using electrical components and connecting wires. But unfortunately, I don't have all of these apparatus and materials with me here, right? But I will try my best to explain to you and using the textbook as a reference. I hope you are with me, okay? The apparatus and materials for this investigation are bulb and bulb holder, dry cell and dry cell holder, connecting wires, and switch. As I said earlier, unfortunately, I don't have all of these materials here with me at home. So, I will refer to this textbook and try my best to explain to you. But don't worry, this is a very simple investigation. Let us look at the steps one by one. Step 1. Fasten the bulb onto a bulb holder. As you can see from this picture, we have to fasten the bulb onto the bulb holder. Step 2. Install the dry cell in a dry cell holder, as shown in the picture here. Very clear, isn't it? Now, let us proceed to step 3. Step 3. Complete the circuit by connecting all components using the connecting wires. As you can see here, this is the positive pole connected to the positive on the dry cell. Positive pole on the dry cell. Meanwhile, the negative pole connected to the bulb holder, and then the connecting wires connected to the switch. Alright, now let us look at step number 4. Close the switch and observe the bulb. As you can see here from the picture, the switch is closed, isn't it? When the switch in this position, we call it close. And observe what happened to the bulb. Look at the bulb here. The bulb lights up, right? So whenever the switch is closed, the electric circuit is completed and the bulb is lights up. Next, step 5. Open the switch and observe the bulb. As you can see from the picture here, the switch is open. So, what happened to the bulb here? Is the electric circuit completed? No, isn't it? So, whenever the electric circuit is not completed, the bulb will not light up. You see the bulb here? It doesn't light up. Okay? I hope you are clear on that. If you refer to your science textbook, page 78, you will find these 3 questions. Alright, now I will help you to answer all of these questions. Let's look at the question number 1. Why does the bulb light up when the switch is closed? The answer is, the bulb light up when the switch is closed because the electric circuit is complete. Why doesn't the bulb light up when the switch is open? So, what do you think this answer? The bulb doesn't light up when the switch is open because the electric circuit is not complete or break. Remember the function of the switch? It is to complete and to break the electric circuit. Alright, so that's very clear. Next, question number 3. The bulb will light up when the switch is closed. The bulb does not light up when the switch is open. I hope you get these answers correct. Now, if you look in page 78 also, there are two more additional questions for us to discuss. Let us look at the hot questions, higher order thinking skills, okay? What will happen to the brightness of the bulb if the circuit is left complete for one day? Why? So, do you know this answer? What will happen to the brightness of the bulb if the circuit is left open? It means the bulb left on, switch on for one day. What will happen? And why? Do you know the answer? I give you 3 seconds to think. 1, 2, 3. Time's up. So what will happen is the brightness of the bulb will decrease because the dry cell will run out of energy, because the bulb gets its energy from the dry cell. If we left it complete for the whole day, the dry cell will run out of energy and eventually the brightness of the bulb will decrease. Very clear, isn't it? Next question. Let's think. List 3 electrical components that need to be connected using connecting wires to build a complete electric circuit. I give you 3 seconds to think. The electrical components that need to be connected. There are 3 main electrical components, isn't it? Alright? 1, 2, 3. The answer is the 3 electrical components that need to be connected using connecting wires are dry cell, bulb and switch. If you got all of these answers correct, very good. That's very awesome. Alright boys and girls, we have done answering all of the questions in page 78. So now, I want you to get ready with your science exercise book and copy all of the questions and the answers that we have discussed just now in your exercise book. As usual, write down the date and the topic for today's lesson, building an electric circuit. Question 1. Why does the bulb light up when the switch is closed? The bulb light up when the switch is closed because the electric circuit is complete. Why doesn't the bulb light up when the switch is open? The bulb doesn't light up when the switch is open because the electric circuit is not complete or break. Number 3. The bulb will light up when the switch is closed. The bulb does not light up when the switch is open. That's it. Easy, isn't it? So you can pause this video and copy this exercise in your exercise book. Now let us move on to your science activity book and refer to page 48. In page 48, you may find this activity. Alright, build a complete circuit. Write down the date, read the instruction, press the correct path of connecting wires to form a complete electric circuit. You may refer to your textbook page 77 and 78, and you have to trace these lines to form a complete electric circuit. Right, the answer is in your textbook. You may refer to your textbook page 77 and 78. So this is very simple and straightforward activity for you. I hope you can do this correctly. Alright everyone, that's about it for today's science lesson. I hope you enjoyed throughout the whole activity and learned something from this video. I see you in the next time in our next video. See you, bye bye.